On this episode of The Donut Shop, what is virtual reality? Virtual reality is a technology that allows you to be anyone, do anything, or go anywhere you can possibly imagine. It's a digital technology that allows you to step inside of a piece of content, inside of a video game, or be part of a film. A lot of times, VR is also grouped with augmented reality, or AR, and 360 video. Those are a little bit different, and we'll talk about those in more detail later, but today, we're gonna stay focused on virtual reality. There's three key components that are required to create a good VR experience. You need the hardware, you need to have trackability, which we'll talk about in a second, and also interactivity. The hardware part's pretty straightforward. You need a VR headset. Most VR headsets have two lenses, because we have two eyes, and a digital screen inside. The second part is that trackability. So you have to be able to move around in a VR experience, and that really is what makes it immersive compared to a video game or a film. On one side note there, real quick, early VR headsets had delay in the trackability of the headset, which caused nausea. So if you haven't tried VR in a while, or the first time you tried it, it made you sick, definitely recommend you give it a try again, because things have changed. All right, so the third component is interactivity. So using controllers, or even your hands in some fancier systems, you actually have the ability to do things inside of a VR experience. That interactivity is key to helping create that presence, and that sense of immersion inside of the VR experience. So where did VR get started? VR has been around since the 1960s, believe it or not. People have been working on this technology for a really long time. However, it wasn't until 2015 when Facebook bought a little company called Oculus, and that is really what pushed this technology into the public domain. However, just in the last 2 or 3 years, the technology has improved massively. You don't need a big, heavy-duty $2,000 computer anymore or hang a bunch of crazy sensors around your room. All you need is a headset, a couple of controllers, and plenty of time to lose yourself in the amazing experiences that are available on these headsets. What are some good use cases for this technology? The first one that most people think about is gaming. Step inside of a video game is a pretty cool thing to do. Another great use case for this stuff, where we're seeing it save hundreds of thousands of dollars in the real world, is training and simulation. UPS is using this technology to train their drivers. The military has been using this for years to train soldiers and pilots and the like. So training and simulation, great, great use cases for this technology. It's also has huge benefits as a sales and marketing tool. Let's say you're an architect and you want to show someone what the inside of your new building looks like. Well, that's hard to do until you actually build the building. With VR, you can now do that. Another great use case for this technology is around the travel, meditation, and also in the healthcare space. So we're seeing this technology used to help diagnose concussions. Let's say you sit in traffic for an hour, you get to work, you're all stressed out. Hey man, pop on your VR headset and go sit on the beach for a few minutes and breathe. You'll have a much better day. So that's it for this episode. Be sure to leave any comments or questions below. We'll get those answered for you. Follow along so you can stay up to date on all the latest and greatest in the virtual and augmented reality industry. And of course, stay hungry.